Sri Honorable Vinay Vishwam Ji. Honorable Vinay Vishwam. Please.
Thank you, sir, for getting a rare opportunity.
Na, name is there, na? Name is there. He's not there. I called him, Mr. Banerjee.
Yes. Sir, the House has been an integral part of our parliamentary democracy. Sir, democracy in our country is deep-rooted. It is not only from the first general elections of 1952, even we go back to the 16 Mahajanapads. There were instances where people chose their own government. There were republics at that time. Now, incidentally, when this House was long ago, as Mr. Vaiko was telling, when he came here, he was very interested to hear to the roar of great people speaking in this House. Now, here in this House itself, many years ago when the House started, there was a discussion about palimpsest. Congress was in large majority, the opposition was there, but the opposition also spoke about the palimpsest. Now, sir, what is palimpsest? Jawaharlal Nehru, our first Prime Minister, invoked the very evocative example of the palimpsest. In ancient times, before the discovery or invention of paper, the palimpsest was either a wooden or stone tablet on which every victor would erase the past history and write his own version of history. But in this very House, as Pandit Nehru, the statesman and the historian, pointed out again, India is an ancient palimpsest on which layer upon layer of thought and reverie had been inscribed, and yet no succeeding layer had completely hidden or erased what had been written previously. That is the beauty of our country. That has been the beauty of the House. And in fact, when the Sino-Indian border conflict was going on, one opposition member of parliament has urged Pandit Nehru to call the parliament. Parliament was convened because Pandit Nehru believed in the battle of ideas. Atal Bihari Vajpayee had urged Pandit Nehru to convene the parliament, and to ensure the battle of ideas, the parliament was convened. Now, unfortunately, sir, we need to ensure at least 100 days of sitting, because this is a place that ensures the battle of ideas. And this is a House of the state, sir, the rights of the states, that has to be the priority that needs to be protected. The working days, as many other members have mentioned, and what Mr. Shiva was speaking out, this House must not stifle voices. The voices, as like people who are sitting here, you also know the pain when you used to sit in the back benches. You know how it is, you go on craving for indulgence to have 1 minute or 2 minutes. So the voices of the members must not be stifled. And most importantly, I, sir, want to quote. I will take maximum a minute. It was actually Swami Vivekananda, while speaking in Chicago, he had said, "I pity him from the bottom of my heart and point out to him that upon the banner of every religion will soon be written, in spite of resistance, help and not fight, assimilation and not destruction, harmony and peace and not dissension." Assimilation, not exclusion, has been the beauty of the House. And as this House, actually, this House represents the unity in diversity, all diversified forces from the country. We have different food habits, different languages, and as I will speak in my mother tongue, for half a minute, I will quote Tagore, the Maverick Tagore. "Keho nahi jane, kar ahohane, koto manusher dhara, durvar srote elo kotha hote, samudre holo ara. Hethai arjo, hethai onarjo, hethai dravir chin, shok hundal pathan mogol, agdehe holo lin. পশ্চিমে আজি খুলিয়াছে দ্বার, সেথা হতে সবে আনে উপহার, দিবে আর নিবে, মিলাবে মিলিবে, যাবে না ফিরে, এই ভারতের মহামানবের সাগর তীরে." The English in a nutshell, that none can tell at whose beckoning vast waves of humanity merged into this very great sea called India. All came, all gave and all took, mingled and also mingled with others. None shall depart dejected from the great shores of the pilgrimage and the idea of India. I believe from the core of my heart that this very House will go on championing the battle of ideas and the idea of India. Thank you, sir.
Dhanyavad Ritabrata ji.